Hey guys, so for today's video, we're going to be talking about my 2018 yearly makeup favorites. I've actually never done a favorites video before on my channel, so I'm really excited to be doing this, and I am here for it. Some of these products did come out in 2018, so they are brand new this year, but then some of these products were released in previous years, but I've just been using them a lot this year, so I want to share that with you. I'm going to start off with my favorite eyeshadow palettes, just because eyeshadow is what I do here on my channel. I do eye makeup tutorials, so I know you guys really want to know what my favorite palettes are from this year. I got some palettes here to talk about and a few more. I don't know where to start. I think I'm going to start off with Anastasia Soft Glam. This is definitely my favorite palette that she released this year. I just love all the matte neutral colors at the bottom, the fun pops of color. I love there's a black and a lighter shade. There's just so many looks you can create with this. You can use something softer, something more dramatic. Her formula is also just so easy to work with, so I really think that anyone can use and will love this palette. Next is the Kathleen Lights and ColourPop Dream Street palette. I ended up liking this palette a lot more than I thought I would. It looks a little plain to me, but I really do enjoy it. Again, you have a really good mix of matte and shimmer shades, and you have some nice warm tones here, fun pops of blue, and some gorgeous kind of softer nude shimmers. It's super cheap, and the shadows are such a good quality, so I highly recommend this one. Another palette I really loved this year was the Dominique Cosmetics Latte palette. For me, when I think of a good eyeshadow palette, I want a palette that has a good mix of matte and shimmers. You'll hear me say that a lot with all of these palettes I'm talking about, but right here you have the whole top row is matte, especially these two, and you have some three shimmers that go nicely with all of the shades. This was the first palette that Dominique Cosmetics came out with, and I think she did a really great job. I did do like two or three tutorials with this, and it's definitely one that I grab a lot, especially when I just want these nice neutral shades. This next palette I don't really want to talk about on my channel. It's another influencer who has their own brand. They're very controversial, but this palette is fucking amazing. It is the Lunar Beauty Life's a Drag palette. This palette is just so amazing. I love the mix of colors, how you have the neutrals on one side and the bright colors on the other side. There's so many looks you can create with this, and I do enjoy the palette, but I don't enjoy the person behind it. I do have to give a quick shout out to the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill palette. It came out last year, but it's still one of my go-to palettes. I bring this with me when I travel because there's just everything I need in here to create so many looks. If you didn't know, I do have over 20 tutorials with this palette. I have a whole playlist on my channel. I will link that for you, so I definitely got some good use out of this guy. A lot of you might ask me about the Jaclyn Hill Vault. While I did like the palettes, it's not one of my favorites. It was just a very controversial release, how everything sucked at first, and then it became better for only some people. I do like the idea of these palettes, but it just didn't work out, so it's not in my favorites. So my next favorite palette is the Violet Voss Flamingo palette. I think it came out this summer or spring or whatever, and it is just so beautiful and bright and colorful. If you're someone who enjoys bright colors, you would love this palette. The formula is amazing, and again, there's a good mix of matte and shimmers. This is a palette that I grab for when I know I want to do a little bit of color. It is just amazing. Speaking of color, I have to talk about the Huda Beauty Mini Obsessions palettes. This is just such a fun idea to have a little color story for each palette. She came out with 5 of these, but I actually gave a friend the purple one because that was my least favorite. My 2 favorites are probably the Emerald and the Ruby. I did do tutorials with each of these little mini palettes, so if you want to see that, you can find those on my channel. I do have to give a quick honorable mention to the Natasha Denona Safari palette. I think I've done like 2 or 3 videos with this palette, and I really, really do love the idea of this palette, the color scheme, how they're all matte. It's so beautiful. I love just looking at it, but I've had some issues with this palette. It doesn't blend amazing for me. Some shades work better than others, so I wish it performed better, but like Tati loves this palette, and I'm like, how do you make it work? It definitely takes time to work with these shadows, but it is just so beautiful. The last eyeshadow palette I think I just have to mention is the Morphe and James Charles palette. This literally has every color you would need to make a colorful eyeshadow look. So if you're someone who needs more colorful eyeshadows in your collection, I highly recommend this palette. It is so beautiful. If you like to do more neutral looks, this palette probably isn't for you, although I did do one neutral look using like these shades, but that's kind of all you can do. But if you like colors, you would love this. So those are my favorite eyeshadow palettes of this year. Let's move on to some more eye products. If you watch my videos, you know that I only prime my eyes with concealer. I don't use a real eye base. So I've been using the Too Faced Born This Way Multi-Sculpting Concealer for my eye base, and I just love this. You'll also see me use this concealer a lot for my cut creases. It's just so easy to work with because it's nice and creamy, but it does dry down and stay in place. The funny thing is, I don't really like to use this for an actual concealer, like under my eyes or on my face. I actually can't find a color I like to use under my eyes for my concealer because I like my concealer to be a little bit more pink toned, which is why my other favorite is Tarte Shape Tape in Light. This has been my go-to under eye concealer ever since it came out and nothing has replaced it. I've tried the ColourPop concealer, the Milk Makeup concealer, but nothing can beat my Shape Tape. My favorite eye makeup brushes would hands down be my brush set with Sigma. This is a limited edition set that just came out this month, but I've been using Sigma brushes for years in my videos. So this set contains my 5 go-to eye makeup brushes that you can use to create any eye makeup look. So my set has the Sigma E35, the E25, the E30 pencil brush, the E21 smudge brush, and the L05 lip brush, but I use this on my eyes, but of course you can use it on your lips. The set is discounted 20% off the retail price, so it is such a good deal, and these are my favorite go-to brushes. So if you need new eye makeup brushes, I highly recommend you check this out. I have 3 different eyeliners that I want to talk about, and they're all different types of eyeliners. The first is the Inglot Gel Eyeliner number 77. This is seriously the most black, intense, pigmented gel eyeliner I've used in my life. I wish I've discovered this earlier. I know it's been out for a long time, but it is just so incredible, and it stays in your waterline forever. It'll stay in my waterline for up to like 5 hours, which is the best that any eyeliner has stayed in my waterline, so this is just such a go-to for me. For a liquid eyeliner, my favorite is definitely the Fenty Beauty Flyliner. Again, it's just so black, so pigmented. It has a nice fine point, and the tip is perfect, so you can do a wing with it or just like a basic eyeliner, but it's just so good, and I've had it since it came out this year and it's still going, so a lot of product in here. And then for a pencil eyeliner, I've been loving the Pat McGrath Labs Permagel Eyeliner Pencil in Black. This is seriously just so creamy and so black. You can use it on your top lash line and your waterline, on your lower lash line, wherever you need, and it stays in place really well. I have 2 pairs of lashes I want to talk about. They are both from the Lily Lashes Sephora collection. First is the style Rome, which I'm actually wearing on my eyes right now. These are just so beautiful, so fluffy, and they're a little bit more natural than the other pair I'm gonna talk about. So I can wear these lashes when I have a full face of makeup on like right now, or if I'm going more natural, they still look so good and not too like overpowering. My other favorites are Mykonos if I want something a little bit more dramatic and even more fluffy and full. They're really just such a good quality, and I love how fluffy they both are. For eyebrows, I have to mention the Benefit Precisely My Brow Pencil. This has been out for a few years now, but it's still my favorite go-to everyday pencil for my eyebrows. I can do a soft brow with this, I can do an intense brow with it. It's just so versatile and it's just amazing. For foundation, my favorite that I've used this year is the NARS Sheer Glow. Sorry, mine is just like nasty. This foundation just looks so good on my skin and it lasts all day on me. For me, it's like a full coverage with a nice kind of dewy finish and it's just so beautiful. For lips, my favorite is definitely the Fenty Gloss Bombs. I really don't like liquid lipsticks. I can kind of wear regular lipstick tubes, but glosses are my favorite thing in the world and these are just incredible. I really love all 3 colors. We have Fenty Glow, Diamond Milk, and Fussy, which is the newer one. I am wearing this on my lips right now. I can wear these when I have a fake tan, when I'm pale, when I just want a little bit of something on my lips. The applicator is huge. It's so comfortable on the lips and it smells amazing. Like, I have nothing bad to say about these at all. It's so good. I love it. We're getting towards the end here. So for highlighter, my favorite highlighter of the year is probably ColourPop Flexitarian. I haven't really talked about it much on my channel, but I do use this a lot off camera. I do have a little bit on my cheekbone right now with another highlighter over it, I think. It is just creamy, buildable, blinding, inexpensive. I really need to check out the other colors of these because it's just incredible. And my new favorite makeup product of this year that I can't really live without and I just recently discovered is the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Luminous Light. I didn't think I would love this as much as I do, but I literally can't do my makeup without it now. It just makes my skin look so healthy and glowy and dewy. Oh, it's so good. I can wear it alone, I can wear it over foundation, over a full face of makeup. It's just so beautiful and like, I can't swatch it because it looks like nothing on my finger. But like, I don't know how I did my makeup without this. I'm obsessed. I want to talk about one more product, which isn't makeup, but it's still a beauty product, and that is Fake Tan. I am an avid fake tanner. I do it year round. I just love looking tan and bronzy all the time. I'm not tan right now just because I'm a little lazy, but my favorite tanner is the Loving Tan Deluxe Bronzing Mousse, and I use the shade Dark. I've used Ultra Dark, but that's a little bit too much for me, and Medium works as well, but Dark is my go-to. I have used so many fake tanners in my life, and this is my go-to one. It is a little bit expensive, but it's totally worth it. It's easy to work with because it's a mousse. You can see the color going on. It doesn't dry patchy. It fades nicely. It dries pretty quickly, but not too quick, which I really like. And I just have nothing bad to say about this. For applying my fake tanner, my favorite new glove, which is kind of random, is actually the Bondi Sands glove. I've used the Saint Tropez mitt, the Loving Tan mitt, but this one is incredible. Bondi Sands sent this to me earlier this year and I was like, okay, cool, another tanning mitt, but it is amazing. It is such a high quality. You can use both sides of the mitt and it is so soft on your skin. Like when you're rubbing it, you're like, oh my God, this feels amazing. I don't know how much this one is, but once this one dies, I'm gonna buy another one because I love it so much. So that is everything in my 2018 yearly favorites. How was that? Was that good? I know I didn't talk about every single type of makeup product. I didn't talk about blush or setting powder or like bronzer or anything, just because I really wanted to pick my all-time favorite products that were a go-to from this year that I couldn't live without. I didn't really have like a go-to favorite blush, bronzer, or powder because I do switch those up a lot. I want to know what your guys' favorites are. Is there anything I'm missing that you think I need, that you think I would love? I would love to know. I am always excited for new makeup launches, so I'm excited to see what comes out in 2019. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe.